our 2019-2020 Performance Series. So we have been so blessed to have such wonderful supporters to make this Performance Series possible. And tonight is a super special occasion because it is our inaugural of our new piano, and we'll be doing the dedication for the piano just before the intermission. But I would also like to thank Sue Ann Lurcott, who has been a longtime supporter of the Performance Series, and she's a sponsor for this season. And of course, I'd like to thank Wanda for being a long time supporter of the museum and the piano that we are going to be performing on tonight. This is a very special evening. I'm so glad you all are here to experience this. The program has been developed to complement our Grand Canyon photographs. So it's an Americana theme. So I hope that you enjoy the music matching with the artwork, and we'll have a whole art experience tonight. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our musicians for the evening. The soprano, Nancy Curtis.
Thank you. thrilled that to be able to honor my dear friend Wanda, our dear friend, and patroness of the arts. My notes tonight will be rather impromptu because I was busy practicing and preparing that, and I didn't spend enough time. So my notes are rather impromptu. You would ask Ellen Americana, why are we doing Italian opera? The answer is because we can. We've all spent a lot of our professional careers doing not just American music. So this next piece is from I Pagliacci, which means the clowns. And Tonio is, he says, I am the prologue. I'm here to explain to you what is going to happen. And so he tells that, he says that the intermingling of life and life on the stage, real life and life on the stage, is a very interesting thing, and all the emotions that it evokes in people. And so he's just explaining what people are going to see with this Commedia dell'arte troupe, which was a stock kind of theater that went on in Europe since the Middle Ages, I think. So, Tonio.
Libero, libero.
Hang on just a second, I'm juggling music here. Samuel Barber, in my opinion, America's greatest composer, wrote what many people think is a quintessential American art song. And I confess I'm a little mystified by the text. It was written by James A.G. about a century ago. And to me, it sounds like a rural kind of person talking out in the open plain area with a back when you could see all the stars, remember that? And I think it was the spirit of hopefulness that Americans had back then, and they felt so tall that they could cast shadows on the stars. And so just a calm, happy, hopeful piece. It's very lovely.
Said, fill my feet. hen said chimmy chop, chimmy chop. My goose said quah, quah. My duck said quack, quack. My cat said zoo, zoo. I bought me a pen, my pet fed me. I fed my pen on the yonder tree. My pig said grip, grip. And my hen said chimmy chop, chimmy chop. My goose said quah, quah. My duck said quack, quack. My cat said zoo, zoo. I bought me a cow, my cow bit me. I fed my cow on the yonder tree. My cow said ba ba. My hen said chimmy chack, chimmy chack. My goose said wah wah. My duck said quack quack. My cat said fill my feet. I bought me a horse, my horse bit me. I fed my horse on the yonder tree. My horse said neigh neigh. My cow said ba ba. My hen said chimmy chack. I bought me a wife, my wife pleased me. I fed my wife on the yonder tree. My wife says, honey, honey. My horse said, nay, nay. My cow said, ah, ah, ah. My hen said, chimmy chack, chimmy chack. My goose said, quah, quah. My duck said, quack, quack. My cat said, no.
She's a beautiful young woman who strings men along when she can. And she goes into a restaurant with an old sugar daddy, and that's gonna be me. And I'm fussy. And she sees her former lover, Marcello, and she gets twisting the knife in the wound, you know, to get under his skin. And because she can.
Oh,
So, just a real brief explanation. Porgy is a poor, crippled black man in South America, southern area of North America, what I mean to say. And but he sings a song about I've got plenty of nothing, and he feels sorry for people that have too many things, so they have to lock their doors when they leave. And I'll just introduce the duet between the love duet between Porgy and Bess is one of the great melodies of American. And this is the first notable instance of jazz permeating into the operatic medium. So, Porgy and Bess.
Folks with plenty of plenty that will bring on
changed all of music when he was about 20 years old or younger. And he invented a whole new style for piano. And this nocturne I'm going to play is one of his earliest pieces, Opus 9, number 2. And it was probably about 19 or 20. And it's kind of iconic, I think. Liberace used to play it a lot, I think. And then after that, I got rhythm. Gershwin's own arrangement for piano needs no more introduction than that. And I want to say that, Calvin, are you going to say something now?
Why don't you play it? I'll come back in.
Okay, but this is dedicated to Rhonda.
Thank you. Calvin Cobb, the chairman of the board of the Pearl Fincher Museum, and I want to thank all of our performers because what they have brought to life was Wanda's vision of what performances at the Pearl would look like. So Wanda, if you could please stand up and let us welcome you here. And let us thank you for everything. And she said, I just decided that the Pearl needed a piano and I was going to buy one. And she said, so she'd never done anything like that before and said she decided that's what she's going to do. So when Fred came home from the office that evening, she said, I told Fred, said, Fred, I'm going to buy the Pearl a piano. Now Fred had been, they'd been married a long time and he knew the right answer. And he said, straight away. So she involved Roger here, so she got her dear friend Roger to say, what kind of a piano do we need for the Pearl? And that was quite a task. So they went out and searched and said, what is going to fit the Pearl? And a lot of us were wondering, this was not designed as a concert hall. You know, this was a museum. So how is a wonderful piano going to fit here? So after a lot of research, Roger came up and selected a piano and played it and said, I think this will work. And so when the piano was moved in and we got ready to have the first kind of performances and concerts, when people were rehearsing and playing in an empty room, it sounded pretty tinny. It was pretty bright in here. And they said, well, we don't know how this is going to be. Then when we got all the people in here and got the piano settled in, it was perfect. And every performer who's been here has said, this is a great space. And so Wanda's vision of putting music here surrounded by whatever wonderful art that we had really brought a whole new dimension to the museum. And so then after that, we transitioned to having the Wanda Pauling performances. So throughout the year, with Roger's help and others, they put together terrific performances. And I think tonight is just an example of the kind of thing that Wanda had envisioned that we would have at the Pearl. And it adds a whole new dimension to our community. You know, where else in our neighborhood can you come to a place like this and hear this wonderful music and be surrounded by wonderful art? So Wanda, we want to thank you for all of that. Restored and renovated. You know, everything you see here is bright and shiny and brand new, just like it was 10 years ago. And when the process of that, a new Steinway was bought to replace the first one that we had. And I worked really hard to say, okay, we're going to put this new piano here. What can we do to enhance the sound? You know, it always had been good, and the performers said it was good. Well, the floor, you know, we always loved this wood floor, but it's been redesigned. The underneath of it has more hollow spaces, and it has more sound characteristics. So when the sound bounces off of it, it's even better than it used to be. So the space was put together not only from a standpoint of having it as an art museum, but having it as a place where we could have wonderful performances and we could have great sound. So the new Wanda and Fred Pauling Steinway Grand Piano was designed to fit into this space. So Roger went out and we had Roger and Ani and Claire went out and played every manner of Steinway piano that they could find in the city, and decided that this was the one. Because it turns out, you know, for a non-music person like me, all of these pianos are not the same. They're all different. They all have, you know, as they're made at the factory, they have different tones and sounds. So they went on an exhaustive search to say, we think this is the one. And so we went through the same process as before. When we got the piano in here, says, how is it going to sound? And so when they played it, Roger said, yes, I think we got the right one. It really fits, and it fits the space and the characteristics of it. And inside the piano, there's a plaque that says the Wanda and Fred Pauling Steinway Grand Piano, to remind us of what Wanda has done. For the first part of tonight and having this wonderful concert to show us and to honor Wanda and Fred and to show us what performances at the museum are like. So I think now we'll have an intermission, so please have some cake and dessert here, and then we'll come back for the second part.
We'll have a short intermission, so please we'll have some more champagne reception and some sweets. And then we will resume shortly after that. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. place your camp?
No, that's my iPod. That's for my stills. This is strictly for video. I video all of the services and the church across the street, and some concerts and stuff. So this one, the other one was getting tired, so like, and I like new toys. That might be the strong one. It does great work. I've got maybe 1,600 videos. And all, I do two services at the church every Sunday. I might miss 3 days a year. And I do some speeches for political stuff. I do it pretty well. And one of the things it's got, like the microphone, is